Hey everybody, it's Steven, SKPlayFast333s, and welcome back to Danganronpa's Trigger Happy Havoc. So, I'm not sure what happened from the previous one because it's been a long time since last week. So, let's try and remember correctly. I usually just spend some time hanging out with friends and everything, but except one thing for sure, that Mondo and Taka were having to fight each other, which I don't know what they're fighting for exactly. I don't know what the strangest thing is going on to happen. What happened to the next day? They got together. So why Mondo and Taka were fighting didn't happen the next day, we'll get together. You know, like a brotherhood thing. You know, something happened like that. So I have no idea what they've gone into the some believe at this point on. But it happened almost to the end of the day. Monokuma having an announcement saying something emergency happened. So I have supposed to be going to the gym, mean something is going to happen. So, we're not sure what happened. It's gonna be Monokuma's motives, I presume, as much. It happens, like, another victim comes. It's not gonna be a dude's one. So, let's see how it will take. Yeah, let's just do this. I can use a map to try to get to the gym, right? No, they mean to do that. Yeah, that's the easiest way to go there. I'm supposed to go to the gym. Oh, there's a Hifumi. Hey, Hifumi. How come you haven't gone in yet?
Why?
Jeez, all you did is just ask.
Why is that?
Mr. Aiki, don't scare me like that!
Really? Really?
Sorry, but we really should go inside.
No, don't go! You can't go!
Why?
That's what my ghost friend is telling me.
Oh, seriously. What? You don't believe in ghosts, don't you?
I don't feel good about it either, but you can just ignore this.
Damn, that's true too!
I
guess we have no choice.
I have to go too. Yep, just go straight to the gym. What kind of Monokuma has been up to exactly? And everyone has been gathered.
Asking us to gather together all of a sudden, like this. What could he possibly want?
Well,
indeed. What might await us this time?
He keeps things interesting, that's for sure.
How is that funny? Can't you smile like a normal person once in a while? Like how the housewives in the classic TV show smiles at the end of the episode.
What the heck?
There is something totally messed up with you if you can laugh at a time like this.
Which of us is actually messed up?
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing in particular. Just admiring, that's all. Jeez, you're always interested with games and everything.
I mean, come on, he's trying to be competitive and all. He's trying to survive. He wanted to plan to kill someone.
I don't want to kill anyone, but I also don't want to stay here. Living in blind denial day after day. I was just admiring how you could live like that. And that still keep your sanity.
What is this?
I'm not in denial!
That reminds me. Remember how you kept talking about how the police or whoever would come help us? Like only a few days ago? How did that turn out? It seems to me there's no sign whatsoever of possible rescue. Well, if we call 911, that'll be the case. But we can't because our phones is out of line or none of them have carried their own cell phones with them.
Well...
Not just...
Huh?
I wonder what actually happened.
Certainly.
It's strange. That's true. There's no way the police would know about it. We're right in the middle of a major urban area. The police sucks!
Well, sucks, I was said.
What the heck has gone on with police? He's supposed to be protect justice, not simple like let their own kids trapped in the school get killed each other one way after another. On the contrary, the master may be just that powerful to take control even of the police.
It might be the case. Maybe the work of the mastermind who did it.
Could it be?
Oh, this might not be related, but...
Then don't say it.
Nope. Gotta say it. What are you gonna say?
It's not like some occult mystery.
It's about last night. I was near the main hall, just staring out into space. What last night? The last time I know when I came last night is having a competitive with Mondo and Taka. When all of a sudden, I heard it.
You heard it. Where did you heard it from?
Huh?
You heard what?
A sound that I don't really know what it was.
What kind of sound?
Well, like I said, I don't really know. Well, that's not very helpful information if you don't know who the heck or the talking or conversation we're talking about. But if I had to describe it,
could it be?
It was like a construction site, I guess. A construction site?
You're serious?
I mean, I could just be making that up. I only just barely heard anything.
You definitely made it up. Must just been the sound of the ocean and that head of yours.
Say what? What you talking about, Toko?
Wait, is that Monokuma? It's gotta be Monokuma, isn't it?
A card that comes appears in Monokuma. That's what suddenly happens.
He's arrived. What hero heard wasn't a sound of construction?
Really? Then where does this sound come from?
But it could have been an explosion. Really?
Huh?
Oh, maybe a machine gun. It kinda sounds like a construction in a way.
Oh jeez, Monokuma, you're weird. You're weird, very weird.
What are you talking about?
Beyond this point, my mouth is zipped. My lips are sealed. I'm fully punctured.
Can you even talk with your mouth? Oh, you're stuffed animal, so you can't talk like that.
It's a secret little secret.
And?
Fine, then let's move on to what you can tell us. Why do you call us all here?
Say what?
You don't been around the old bush, do you? Ready for me to get to the point, huh?
If you please.
But before that, you mind if I invent a little...
What?
I'm low on energy these days. My stitching even loses all of its shine and luster.
Why, are you losing your stuffings?
I'm thinking it's probably become this ho-hum, boring old everyday life. I'm looking for something with a little more simulation. Something rife with danger and intrigue.
Yep.
Listen, can I be just a be frank?
Today,
the next black guy hasn't shown up yet. And I'm getting bored!
Well, of course, no one's murder anything.
Hey,
So, I decided to come up with a new way to motivate you.
Here comes another motor once again. What kind of motor are you gonna put us this time?
Motivated? Is it another set of videos or something?
Yeah, like what happened the first part.
Are you gonna show us the 10th thing to try and drive us all to murder?
Drive you to murder?! Mean thing to say. Just awful.
You hear me?
I don't know what you got planned, but we're not going to kill each other anymore.
Got it.
No matter what you do, I swear to God, we won't.
Yeah, you tell him, Taka.
That's very big talk. Do your very best to back it up, okay? Now then, with your permission, let's begin.
Okay then.
So this time it's embarrassing memories and secrets.
Embarrassing memories and secrets.
Yeah, and strangely enough, everyone happens to keeping a secret with the nobody's for sure.
Like they happen like a disorder or something to keep it the gender
high end stuff. That's not a secret.
You don't want anything to experience with exactly.
As long as you're alive, it's a given that there are what things you don't want other people to know about.
But don't let the secrets out, isn't it?
So, I did a little investigating of my own, and I dug up some of your darkest secrets.
Wait, how did... Oh.
And those embarrassing memories and secrets are all contained in the envelopes I have right here.
Wait, hold on. Monokuma, first things first.
How do you know their secrets exactly? That's impossible. You can't, like, seriously look it up or anything. Unless...
You must look up into their data or something. I have no idea.
I'm going to hand them out now. So take a second to take a peek.
As Malcolm was spoken, he tossed the envelope at our feet. I quickly snatched the envelope with my name written on it.
Okay, what kind of embarrassing secrets what they have in store for us?
I never saw him pull out what was written inside. And my entire body suddenly went regret.
Makoto wet the bed until he was in the fifth grade.
Holy jeez, wow!
No wonder what kind of embarrassing stuff with Makoto's exactly. Okay, I don't know how did this happen. This is most embarrassing stuff.
What?
Oh.
How? How'd you find out about this?
Everyone started talking at once.
It's like Monokuma knew everything. Like what their secrets we have. Like how did he do it exactly? Yeah, 21 hours! If someone doesn't become blacker by then, all your deepest, darkest, most embarrassing secrets will be exposed to the world!
Oh no, this is not good at all. If no one gets killed, then whole secret stuff will be revealed to the entire world, and people might got laugh and tweet at everyone and post at everyone and say, oh my gosh, look at the embarrassing stuff that they did. Exactly, yes.
That's not good. This is not good. Monokuma, you are such a worst thing. Maybe I'll roll by a crowd interaction in the van strapped with the loudspeakers and spill the beans.
My college did for the voters.
Yeah!
Wouldn't that be so embarrassing?
So that's what you mean by motivated?
Yeah, you got it. They're all pretty unpleasant. Trust me. None of you want me to reveal the stuff, right? It's definitely something I'd rather people not know. But we'll never kill over something like that.
Wait. Well, that's Monokuma. Sorry.
We'll never kill over something like that.
What
you said?
Count on it.
He's smart. Your plan is doomed to fail. No one's gonna murder someone for this kind of thing.
Well, if nothing happens when 21 hours haven't come, then the secret's revealed, isn't it?
This is kind of.
Oh no! Is it because, for better or worse, your memories are still a way to connect to the outside world? I have stuff I wouldn't want anyone to know, no matter what. So I assume you'll be the same. Which is why I put so much effort into preparing this next motive. Man, you're saying you really won't kill each other over this stuff? That just sucks. Well, what can you do? Okay, in 21 hours, I'll expose all your secrets just to make myself feel a little better.
Okay.
So sad, so depressed. For not well.
Really? We put the knot between the farewell thing? With the almost convincing look of the depressed dejection on his face, Monokuma receded into the gym's depths.
So,
I didn't know what to expect at first, but maybe we dodge a bullet on this one. Having those secrets revealed is gonna be totally embarrassing. But that's seriously not enough to give someone a reason to kill, right?
Listen to me!
Good news, everyone! I have a brilliant idea!
You hear me?
Why don't we all just confess the secret? And those envelopes right here and now.
Without a doubt.
If we do that, any and all motives for murder will vanish. That's pretty smart, right?
Well, if we tell us the secrets, that'll be fine, but you will still gonna reveal it to the entire world, you know.
Quiet down and listen.
Okay, so my embarrassing thing is, I don't want to hear your stupid story. What? Besides, I don't want to talk about it. I don't care what anyone said. I don't want to talk about mine.
As for me,
neither I. Not because it's unpleasant, but because it is impossible.
Oh,
it's just a human nature to want to hear it when you say it's impossible. Come on, it'll be good for you. Absolutely not.
Come on,
it's okay.
Come on.
Just a little bit. Come on, come on, come on.
Jeez, if you want some more secret. If you want some secret, tell me yours!
Honestly.
As I said.
Here we go!
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on! Kifumi, you better not try and upset Celeste, otherwise she will just anger you, scold you.
Hey!
I said when I talk about it! You human bag of lard!
Say what?
Told you! I told you!
I agree with them. There's no need to discuss it.
What do you think, Chihiro?
I'm sorry.
I don't really want to talk about it right now.
But
I also don't want to leave things the way they are. So maybe I can talk about it later. After I try my best to become strong, then I can tell everyone.
So
if you don't want to talk, you don't have to.
not super excited to talk about it either.
That's true.
Everyone's that much against it, even if my bro is the one that suggested. I'm gonna say no.
Well, that's okay then. Either way, if it's just a few secrets, I'm sure nobody's about to kill anybody over it.
I hope you're right. A secret's so bad, you kill someone to keep it. Nobody's got something like that, right?
Okay, I'll stop with all this secret talk. But
you hear me?
Each of us has 24 hours to get ready. Having a secret exposed isn't going to be fun, but it's not like we're gonna die because of it. So you know, don't do anything hasty.
The way you keep repeating it kind of makes me worry even more.
Oh, okay, sorry. I know it's gonna be tough, but...
Okay, it's on nighttime already. So it's only 10 a.m., right?
Let's add Fudge to the doors to the dining hall, okay then?
I know about it already. Shut up, I don't care about it.
Nighttime already? Huh. Okay, let's all call it a day.
Of course.
Good idea. We need to prepare for tomorrow.
I was left with anxiety I just couldn't shake, but... We left things as they were, we left things as they lay.
What, the letters?
One by one, we head back to our rooms.
Yeah, I can see how the McCullough's name's in there.
Secrets or memories you don't want anyone to know about. A way to connect to the outside world. Honestly, all that crap Monokuma was spouting didn't have any effort on me. There's no way anyone would kill over stuff like that. At least, that's what I thought. But maybe I was just being optimistic. Which is probably why, without too much of a struggle. Jeez, I'm more tired than usual. Super tired today.
Yeah, I fell asleep.
But what I didn't know is that even a tragedy was taking place.
Oh no, please tell me he's gonna get killed during nighttime, just like with Cyagos. I don't like it. And Monokuma at the end, of course.
Hey, do you have a second? I'm gonna confide in you. It's about the prevailing world attitude right now.
What is that?
The difference between passive and active. I mean, for example, the difference between like, oops, kill him, and yeah, that's right, I killed him. Amazingly, there are tons of people who don't understand the differences. Can you believe it?
No, I don't believe it.
But there's a huge difference between oops and that's right. You know what I'm saying, right?
Don't get it.
Anyone can kill someone in the heat of a moment, but surprisingly few can do it with calculated intent. To make the choice, then put it into action. It's way harder than just letting your emotion lead you. It's all about preparation.
Resolve.
So maybe you're wondering, what's the point I'm trying to make?
Well, I'm not totally sure myself. Maybe you should try reading between the lines.
You mean how to say it? I don't get this.
Morning. Good morning.
Who's talking to me?
Good morning!
Oh, jeez, Monokuma! You appear out of my nowhere! Up, up, up! Nice reaction! I'm glad to see you didn't disappoint.
What? What are you doing here?
Yep.
I want to spice this up, so instead of school announcement, I decided to wake you up in person.
Why didn't you make an announcement, Sonny? What is it?
What's the H for?
Because it's fun!
That's not a reason why.
Had a song that I'm here, I think I'll let you hear right from the bear's mouth.
Hear what?
Are you sure you should be acting this laid back? I mean, even though something happened to one of your buddy classmates.
Oh no, please tell me someone's getting killed already. Oh no.
What?
Say what?
What? Your face is all blue, like someone's on the verge of dead.
What happened? What are you talking about?
That for me to know and you to find out. Good luck!
Oh no. Something happened to someone.
Is it? Was it? No, it can't be. There's no way someone would. But what if? No, what ifs are pointless, especially now when. The dining hall. I need to get to the dining hall.
Yeah. You better sure to know who was it that got killed exactly.
Makoto!
Are you okay?
Hey!
Did Monokuma talk to you too?
Hiro, Hina, Sakura, and...
Byakuya. Who else is missing? Toko, Mando, Hifumi, Taka, and Chihiro. That's five. Oh, it's Celeste. Six. There's six of them we're missing.
Byakuya. You're the only ones here? Where's everyone else?
Either they're already trying to verify what Monokuma said, or they've fallen victim to the something that Monokuma mentioned.
The something?
Perhaps.
It can't be. It has happened again.
Murder?
Murder?
After hearing what Monokuma has to say, the worst possible day forced its way into my mind. It took everything I had to drive that thought away.
So if someone really did happen, does that mean someone did it because of what happened yesterday?
Huh?
It can't be! That stuff was just a bunch of old memories!
Just old memories? Don't be so sure about that. Clearly someone felt it was more important than that.
Huh?
To judge someone else's values based on your own outlook, do you realize how dangerous that is?
What the heck?
Why? Didn't you say something yesterday?
Naturally.
Did you already forget? This isn't a co-op game. It's every man for himself. This isn't like a campaign or story mode or everything. What good does it do me to go out of my way to help you?
Just the word.
Stop saying that already!
There's something wrong with him. For serious. Did he get brainwashed or something?
Wait.
That's not important. What matters right now is that we find out what happened.
That's fine.
She's right. Let's all split up and begin looking. The game is afoot. I have a bad feeling about this. So we better figure out what the heck is going on here. So, I just gotta talk, check around places to know who got killed exactly. Oh man. I'll talk to Hina.
So,
I knocked on all the doors, but nobody answered. Did no one go to see what happened? Oh, then what about the second floor of the school? That's the one place that's new to all of us, so it seems like natural floor.
Yeah, for sure. Before that, I want to check out some other places. There's like bathhouse and the warehouse. There's one in the bathhouse. I'll try to investigate it for a bit, just in case if something happens. That's quite the bathhouse around here. There's a locker room. Nothing interesting around here. Okay, this is what the bathhouse looked like. Now for the warehouse. Where did the warehouse go exactly? Okay, this is the warehouse. Wow, that was a lot of it from warehouse. Yeah, I never seen it before. Yeah, this was nothing. Okay, I think that's enough exploring for the bathhouse and warehouse. I'm gonna check the places that I've never seen before, so... So we had to go to the second floor, right? Something strange, bad things gonna happen right here. I have a bad feeling about this. Hey, yes, Hiro!
Yo!
Hey, Mikuno! Honestly, what do you think? Huh? About what?
For serious?
About Byakuya. You think he's been brainwashed or what?
I don't know. You know more about that than kind of thing to me, right?
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, I mean, you're some kind of psychic, right?
Hey.
Listen, Mikuno, I think you completely misunderstood what it is I do. Okay, listen, fortune telling is like...
Well?
It's totally different from brainwashing or hypnosis or any of that scientific bullcrap. I don't get that, what that word means. I need you to understand that.
So you expect me to think fortune telling isn't pure science?
Sorry, I don't want to get yelled at. Of course, anyway. Anyway, let's go to the second floor. Let's just check around places. This is a nurse's office. There's no way we'll be in it yet. Okay, on to the second floor then. No, I got a bad feeling about this. Can we go to the... No, this one's closed. Where else can we go? Did I miss the spot and everything? Oh yeah, this way. The pool. I got a bad feeling we had to go to this place. Let me check the boys' locker room. Huh? The door's open.
But aren't they supposed to be locked?
What's that mean? Is that the body discovered?
For this investigation, I have unlocked the doors. Please look around to your heart's content.
Oh no. Oh no. Investigation?
It's all clear now.
Just as I thought.
But Iwakuya!
I see.
Judging from what he's just said, there can be no doubt a murder really was taking place.
Oh no, who did it? Who was getting killed? Come on!
And the locker rooms. They're suspicious. Very suspicious indeed. Wouldn't you agree?
Why are you acting very suspicious, Byakuya? You knew something's gonna happen. You're very acting suspicious!
Huh? Suspicious? It seems nobody searched the locker rooms. Let's start with the girls' locker room.
Can we check the boys' locker room instead?
He was muttering as if talking only to himself. Without waiting for a reply, he pressed his hand against the girls' locker room door. And the door swung open without a sound. Or did you just creak it out? In a moment, time seems to be freeze. Oh no, who is it? Who was it? What?
Chihiro! No! No, why Chihiro? Why? Oh my gosh, she was my favorite of all! She's a programmer! Programmer like me! Why her? What? I don't know how long it took for me to fully comprehend the reality of what I was looking at. But as soon as I did...
Okay, she's screaming a lot for already. What is it?
A wild, almost prevailed scream escaped from my mouth. Oh no, why Chihiro? Who killed Chihiro for this?
Deadly life.
Oh man, that's where the investigation begins, doesn't it? That's not right!
I tried to suppress my screaming, but it was useless. He surged out of me, like water from a spring gushing out of the ground. Byaku, on the other hand.
What? You didn't freak out?
Very strange.
Most unusual, don't you think?
Why are you been acting very cool for no reason, Buster? Why are you acting very cool? You're supposed to be freaked out!
He was totally calm, almost like he was watching this all unfold in front of the TV screen.
I see.
Look, Chihiro Course has been suspended somehow.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. Why is it suspended? Is that a rope thing?
And something been written on the wall in blood. Oh, it says bloodlust. What that even mean? Bloodlust? Such a brutal way to kill someone.
No.
This is beyond brutal. Wouldn't you agree?
Why is it you're being so calm? You must have known something. I get the suspicious feeling you might be the killer, Byakuya.
The killer? How could it not be brutal? No, that's not my point. This murder is far too bizarre for any everyday amateurs to have committed it. Unlike with Sayaka, this murder was not a crime of passion or necessity. It's almost as if whoever did it for fun. You see what I mean, don't you?
I don't get what you're talking about, Byakuya!
What? My head was swimming. I was still really too confused to understand what he was trying to say. And before I could even begin to clear my head...
What the heck?
That's everyone's here, right?
Hey! I heard screaming! There's something... Chihiro!
Oh, it comes to the announcement. That's three people, right? McCullough's the first one discovered. And Byakuya. And Tucker. Right? Oh, no.
A body has been discovered! After a certain amount of time, which you may use however you like, the class trial will begin!
Dang it! Why, Monokuma, why you had to do this to me, not to my Chihiro? What the heck was that?
What?
Ah, that's right. You were unconscious during Sayaka, so you don't know about it. We just heard was a body discovery announcement. Apparently, when three or more people discovered a body, an announcement plays to let everyone know.
Okay, McCullough is the only one didn't know about the body discovery announcement.
Okay, that's good to know, but I already figured out already. Like when something dings, that's what happens.
I imagine it's so that the search for the culprit can proceed fairly for everyone involved.
Proceed fairly? The body discovery announcement? Toshihiro really is...
dead. Yes. Before you start screaming your head down, go around everyone up. It seems another game has begun. Another life or death game to become a killer.
Jeez, Bianquia, why is it you're interested with everything?
Tucker bolted out of the locker room. As everyone made their way to the scene, it felt as if no time at all passed. It was like my sense of time had just taken wing and flown away. When I finally came back to myself, I saw everyone had the same look of confusion, anger, fear, and anger. We all just stood there, gathered around Chihiro's body.
Oh man.
Damn.
Oh my gosh, look at that sucker's face. There's some anger issue.
Damn! I couldn't keep her safe.
So there's another victim! Which means we are now in the same position once again.
Man.
What the F is this?
It's a dream! This is a dream! It's all just a dream!
Well, face it, it's all reality. This is not a dream, man.
In fact, I haven't even been born yet! I don't have any memories of ever being alive!
Leave for me! Call yourself up, man!
Shut up.
At least Lisa's okay. Can we talk to Kyoko about this? I mean, she's a good at investigating. Oh, to check the body or anything? For now, pay attention to the wall.
Huh?
I said once already, there's a weird thing there.
On a wall?
The one with bloodlust in it? The word bloodlust is written on the wall in blood.
So... I don't think it's kind of dying message.
Yeah, why is it put dying bloodlust to zigzag?
It just was too strange.
But you know, that thing about writing bloodlust in blood, does it sound kind of familiar?
What familiar? A murderous fiend who kills again and again using their bizarre and brutal method.
Oh, are you talking about Genocide Jack?
The serial killer? At the scene of each crime, the word bloodlust is written in the victim's own blood.
Are you saying Genocide Jack is the one who's a killer?
They're like a ghost, attacking something then slipping away before the police can catch up to them. And what nickname did the internet give to this mysterious serial killer?
Genocide Jack! Genocide Jack!
Genocide Jack, the murderous fiend whose grisly attacks were famous all across the country. The ultimate murderous fiend, creating a reputation of abnormal, downright cruel killings.
What is this?
This is some copycat killer trying to imitate Genocide Jack's style?
Unless someone is Genocide Jack. But no one revealed their own true identity.
But why would anyone do that?
Perhaps it's a work of the real Genocide Jack.
Who is the real Genocide Jack exactly?
The real? Wait, are you saying Genocide Jack is here in the school?
But we don't know who is Genocide Jack is exactly, but
we don't even know who Genocide Jack is.
No way!
There's no way! But going so far as to write bloodlust at the scene, I'm surprised at this stupidity.
Well,
I can't imagine a worse situation than dealing with this stupid murderer.
What is it now? Toko!
Hina was pointed towards the entrance to the girls' locker room.
What's wrong, Toko?
Toko was the last to arrive, and now she was just standing here.
No! Why? 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 Why?
Why? Is she fainted already? She fainted! That did not sound good!
Seriously, why is she fainted? It's because she saw blood.
Toko!
Hina rushed over to the collapsed Toko and started trying to shake her awake.
Toko, are you okay? Come on, wake up! Oh, that's right! I just remember what she said about how she faints anytime she sees blood.
Yeah. She did so those, I think, from the...
I think it's someone from Juku and Nishima's killed. So she is a hemophobic?
I imagine she does not watch too many horror films then.
This is a violation of the rules, right? I mean, technically she passed out somewhere beside her room.
No, I think you should be okay.
The regulation prohibits sleeping. Like on purpose. Ah, so since she didn't faint on purpose, it doesn't count. Gotcha.
Just a second.
Toko, can you hear me? Hey, you gotta wake up!
As she heard her, Toko suddenly shot awake. As it, she literally jumped up from where she was laying. It was such a strange reaction, I was a total loss for words. She leaped straight up into the air, changing her stance as she did. In no time flat, she was just standing up.
Why are her tongue sticking out like that? And her eyes? What? What's going on with you, Toko?
With no physical contortation, she had to go through her motion with totally haphazard hazard.
Huh? What? Sorry about that. I was just so shocked, you know? It happened, right? Was I the only one?
Toko, are you okay?
I'm fine. Yeah. Whoa, is that a dead body? Hey, are you dead?
Toko, you're not acting like yourself, man. You're acting very strange. And what's with your derpy eyes exactly? And what's with this strange laugh?
What the heck?
She must have hit her head real hard when she faints.
The world has a front and back, a top inning and a bottom. I see your truth in this web of lies. This is quite shiny. I mean, she sounds completely different. No. Everything's fine. At least the stunner is all gone. That's a good thing, right? Yeah!
I see.
It's clear to me that everything is not fine. Your eyes seem strangely vacant.
Listen, it might be best if we take her back to her room for the time being.
So, I don't mind taking her, but could someone help me?
Mm-hmm. If you need help, I don't mind.
Toko, could you help me?
Ah! She totally ignored me!
Very well, you take care of the girl, and the rest of us can begin the investigation right away. Can I assume nobody has a problem leaving Sakura and Mondo on guard duty again?
Well, if we do that guard duty again, because they're all tough and everything.
Hold on a second, rushing to investigation?
The mastermind isn't behind that. After what happened last time, surely you realize that. There's no question that your hero was murdered by someone among us. Isn't that right, Monokuma?
Wait, Monokuma's here already?
Of course!
Rain is rain! You gone really quick the timing when Byakuya called you!
But don't take it as bad thing, it's just a fact of life! Because...
Yay!
That's how graduation works!
Not exactly!
Then, it happened again? Is that what you're saying? That's another one of us? Another one of us killed a fellow classmate? What?
Does that freak you out? You guys got no balls, you know that?
Okay, not with the balls and everything. You're gross.
Is there just nothing down there at all? Well, I'll use your prey to my new ones. Actually, I don't have any either. Sorry!
Well, because you only have a belly button, obviously.
Stop
monologuing and give us what you came here to give us. You did bring it, right?
Oh yeah, the Monokuma file.
Give me some juicy stuff.
I sure did, chum. Allow me to present the next Monokuma file. I know how much you must be looking forward to it.
See?
So please do your very tippy top best on this investigation.
No way!
Do we really gonna do another investigation?
We have to.
Examine the corpse of one of our friends. Having to suspect all of our friends.
Why?
I hate this. I can't take it anymore.
Oh, I hate that too.
I have enough. I'm getting out of here.
Hey.
Where do you plan on going? There's nowhere to run.
Such ignorance.
Just accept it already. After all, blood is just a liquid. A dead body is a simple object.
You're very enthusiastic about all of this, are you not?
Naturally.
How can I not be? If we don't unmask the culprit, we all die.
Yeah. How far do you want to do?
That's true, but to jump into soon.
What?
What? Do you want to die? Fine, then go off and die somewhere. Right now, go ahead. You're a waste of space. The bunny is an object!
Piece of shit!
Chihiro wasn't an object! Show us a little respect, or I'll beat some into you!
calm down.
Everyone stop bickering. Listen, there's some truth in what Byakuya said. Kyoko!
Because...
if we don't solve the mystery and find the killer, our lives are forfeit. And if Byakuya is right that Genocide Jack is somehow that one who killed Shiro,
that's right.
Then unless we do something, more victims could start piling up.
What? Forget more victims! If we mess this up, we're all on dead meat!
Hey! Hey!
Hold on, hold on! If that's your worry, you don't gotta worry any longer! If anyone kill again, the guilty party may only kill a maximum of 2 people!
Wait, so you only killed 2 people?
What? I don't remember any world like that!
Actually...
I just came up with that! I mean, if one person went around and killed everyone, your lovely still alive will be all over, right?
Noodle oil has been added to the regulation menu.
Seriously, you're added already?
So then.
In that case, why not limit it to 1 person?
Hey!
Well, it's a good mistake. You don't want to miss out on at least the potential of a serial killer angle. Just one would totally murder that possibility. Farewell for now. I'll catch you guys at the classroom.
I can't say I understand this thinking, but if we can kill up to 2 people, then one more person's life will still be in danger.
Which is definitely not good. We need to uncover the culprit before something else happens.
You son of a bitch!
You need to shut the F up!
Well, for now, Taka and me are gonna drop Taka off her room.
Nice! I'm gonna get dropped off!
There is nothing to
we have no time to stand around here. We must begin investigation. Totsu. If we don't ask solve the mystery of who killed Chihiro,
okay?
Then we will quickly follow her into the afterlife. That's true. I hate this, but if I want to survive, me and everyone else, we have to do it. We don't have any other choice.
Investigation time.
First of all, I better check the Monokuma file to see exactly what's going on. Yeah, before we start, I think I'm gonna leave it for now, but I'm gonna check the Monokuma files, then I'm not gonna leave it for now. The victim was Chihiro Fujisaki. The time of death is estimated to be around 2 a.m., which is around nighttime. The body was discovered in a girl's locker room on the second floor of the school. The cause of death was a blow to the head with a blunt object. She was killed instantly.
Okay. She immediately got killed. That's all it says. Well, it's not like there are any point complaining about it. No matter what, I gotta do what I gotta do. Yep, can't just see a Monokuma file. Hey Mikoto, do you have a sec?
Huh?
Really, is there more to it?
Did you need something from me?
Naturally.
Of course. Life without purpose is quite dull, you know? So, what do you need?
I'm going to let you cooperate with me during my investigation.
Huh?
What?
I'm purchasing your talent. The same talent which allows you to solve Sayaka's case.
Solve? No, just...
stop talking.
You seem to be some limited use, which is why I have chosen you. You have the honor of contributing to my investigation.
Your investigation? It's everyone's investigation, Byakuya.
So you're inviting me to come with you.
You're doing it in the most arrogant way possible, though.
Let's go.
Now then, shall we get started?
But...
we need to get moving. There's no time to be standing around.
I don't really know what just happened. But it looks like I'll be working with Byakuya on this one.
Yeah. Truthfully.
So I'm gonna leave it from now on, because investigation is happening. The first victim, Chihiro Fujisaki. My favorite character of all. I got killed. I mean, why? Who would do this to something stupid nonsense? But we're gonna do something really quick. We're gonna do a more investigation. And then it happens, we're gonna do some class trial. So know how long the investigation goes and how far it will take for the class trials and see who is the guilty person. It could be Genocide Giant, the one who killed Chihiro, or it might be someone else's. We won't know. So anyway, that's pretty much it for Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc. If you like this video, hit the like button to light them up. If you want to see my videos or check out the other videos, subscribe. Until then, see you guys next time.